Hello, friends. Welcome to Great River School. I'm always happy to say that when you walk in the building. I'm so glad we're meeting together at this time and place in our lives, and I want to acknowledge that we are living, breathing, and working on Dakota land. This very land belongs to 11 of the indigenous peoples' tribes, and they hold the sacredness of the land and the water dear to their hearts. We should too. I want to thank your parents and ancestors for bringing you to Great River School. Thanks too for honoring me by asking me to give your keynote speech. I'm almost speechless, but I know that I have to say something to you, some words of wisdom, some fodder for thought. And so I'm happy, happy, happy to be your graduation speaker. Thanks for the invite. So I was trying to remember what words were said at any one of my graduations. I graduated from high school in 19, and it's been a few years. Unfortunately, I cannot remember one word that was said at my high school graduation. And while that relieves some of the pressure I'm feeling, it also, there's still a different kind of pressure that comes about. My goodness, what a year or 14 months it has been. It's been chaotic for every single one of us. And I'm just curious to know how you are doing. Our routines and habits have changed, and now we're moving back into more of a social realm of existence again. It's easy to wish we could simply go back to the way it was before times. But so many of us were on autopilot in the before times. And now that we are more awake, we can make changes that are both positive and inclusive in the way that we live our lives. We have pushed up against a lot of death and loss. For instance, COVID took two of my relatives, my dad's twin brother and my mom's first cousin. And I can't even picture 600,000 people. The amount of people the United States has lost, many good citizens, 600,000 due to the pandemic, and I can't picture it. Also, here in the Twin Cities, we've experienced another death. We've experienced the murder of George Floyd, and how that impacts us is different for everyone and dramatic for everyone. Please, in your future, do not settle for what we had in the before time. Go out and make a path that's inclusive and positive and one that you can be proud of, one that will help people. Okay, so you are graduating from Great River School. It was just so exciting. It's become obvious to me then because of that I need to say a little something about bodies of water, rivers, you know, Great River School, and lakes, bodies of water that surround us. So I want to talk about the ripple effect. And you know, when you drop a stone into a lake, how it'll start with a little ripple that extends out to another one, little waves of ripples that affect more and more of the water surface. And so I want to talk about that, the ripple effect, and mention a few points of interest to bring to your attention today. First, know that words matter. Words that you choose to use in your daily life matter remember the phrases, I'm sure you've heard, what goes around comes around, and what you give out returns to you multifold. And part of that deals with the words that you choose to use. Once I worked with a nationally known principal of a school in New York City, and she told me that the way she talked with her teachers was to ask them to think, when they're speaking, of being speaking into a microphone that is broadcast throughout the school. So just imagine if every single thing you said came out so loud and clear. This idea got me thinking about the words I choose to use and the ripple effect that they have on the people I meet, as well as the people they meet. If I'm agitated when I'm talking about something, I give off negative vibes, which infect innocent people nearby. I want my words to be words of comfort and words of support and words that make people smile, really and truly. And now I want to know, how do you want your words to impact the people around you? You know, with the ripple effect, it's not just the person you're talking to. It's the person who overhears your conversation. It's the person who's on the other end of the person you're talking to's day. A parent might go home and if having been verbally challenged, might take that out on their child. You know what I mean. So watch the words that you use and how they will affect and infect other people. So now let's talk about, what does success mean to you? Is it lots of money? Is it maybe a job title, like, oh, I am the president of Company Z? Or is it simply keeping yourself alive? Different people have different views of success. And while it's important to strive for what you consider successful, it's also important to know that not everyone is searching for or striving for the same thing. What does success mean to you? And it's important to remember, as a part of this, that everybody has a story. And we don't know the story of people around us necessarily. So it's really important not to judge somebody else's story, or even your own. Give yourself a break if you have a troubling part of a story. I know I was speaking with somebody at the senior picnic, and I had said that I have the ability to faint pretty easily. And while it may be a gift in a way, it's something that not everybody knows about me. And it's something that doesn't matter in most cases, but it is still part of my story. And it's part of what makes me up. Makes me up, yeah. Part of my life. So it's important to remember, just take it easy with other people. Take it easy with yourself. You don't have to judge everybody. It's not up to you. Okay, so now, you know that your parents have once been your age. And so if you run into a situation, a problem, it's maybe important to remember that your parents have also lived through your age, have lived through some of the similar struggles that you will encounter, your parents also have already encountered. So if you're in a spot, a rough patch is what I call it, if you're in a rough patch, please consider asking your parents for some assistance. I think it's really important to ask for help, and I know it's very difficult sometimes to ask for help. But you could start with your parents. You could reach out to trusted people from Great River School. You know, just because you're graduating does not mean that we will never cross paths again. So please ask for help. You know, those finger cuffs, the woven bamboo in a, it's like a cylinder. And if you stick your fingers into each end, then to get them out, if you struggle, the more you struggle, the worse it gets. And if you can think of that as a metaphor for a problem, a rough patch that you're in, remember the finger cuffs. Remember that the more you struggle to get out of them, the harder it is. The problem becomes much worse. And so if you just accept the rough patch, ask for help, it's easier. Your fingers will move together more in the metaphor, and you will be able to get out of your situation easier. Ask for help. And also, try to create like a community or a web or a resource that will give you safety in your life. Put together a group of people who you can talk to in a situation. And I think the more safety net that you can create for yourself, the easier the goal will be, the life will be. Now, here's something I wanted to talk about that everybody I know has, and yet at the development of life, the stage of life that you are at right now, it's not finished. I'm talking about your prefrontal cortex, where all of your decisions are made. Now, I've heard through my studies, I'm a licensed therapist in the state of Minnesota, through my studies to become that type of career person, I've had to study about the prefrontal cortex and how old you are approximately when yours is fully formed. And I've heard anywhere ranging from 24 years old to 26 years old. And women's prefrontal cortex is finished before men's is. There's all sorts of information about that. But the thing I want to point out is that decisions that you make at your age may not be the best decisions. Oh, at any age, but your prefrontal cortex is not completely formed yet, and so you don't have all the information you need to make some critical decisions that will affect the rest of your life. I anticipate that you will all, you know, complete your development and have a good go of life. Part of that's about your motivation, but I want you to consider right now, some decisions you make, you might need a little more research before you make the decision. Now, if you're in a situation where you're overwhelmed with whatever rough patch it is, always remember what you love, what brings you joy. To revert back to what you love to do as a child can sometimes help you manage and get through a tough spot in your life. Did you love to paint watercolor? Did you love to collect rocks? What is it that you love to do as a child? If you can go back and repeat that activity, I have found it makes me feel better if I can go back to what I loved as a child. Just to let go of some of the daily trauma, the daily duties, the daily stress. Just be nice to yourself and do something that you love, that you've always loved. And maybe you haven't done it in forever because you've been growing up. But keep that in mind. That's something to think about. Here's one. Try not to make enemies. Enemies! Try not to make enemies. I've found, especially in work life, that the world is pretty small and that people you have met in your life may come back into your future path. And so Don't make enemies. Because the person that you may disagree with at one point in your life, they may come back to be someone who can help you so much in a future life, future path, not a future life. Well, maybe a future life. So what I'm saying is, for instance, if I was in a job and the person I worked for was irritated with me and chose inappropriate words, I don't want to burn my bridges with that person, as in speaking negatively of them, speaking as if they no longer mattered in my life, because I may need them in the future. And to overcome that is really difficult. The burning of bridges, it's hard to overcome that. So keep in mind, don't try not to make enemies. Now let's talk about who you are. Who you are. And I just want to say in that regard, please continue to have the courage to be who you are. Because our society, it might feel like it doesn't want you to do that. It doesn't want you to be who you are. But I know from working with you at Great River School that each of you has courage. And to stand up for yourself, to advocate for your friends, to, you know, just be courageous enough to be the person that you are, that you choose to be, that is remarkable. And I admire you so much for having that strength. So finally, I'd like to say, I hope that you can go into summer in a creative way while making space to reflect on how you want your life to be. How are you going to carve out your life's path? And it can change. You can get partway there and decide, well, this is not what I want. I want something else. So you can change your path. But I want you to be brave enough and strong enough to dare to do things that matter to you. And if you are brave enough, often enough, you'll make mistakes. You'll fall. There will be challenges. If you can allow yourself to make those mistakes, that's how we learn. And to remember that what happens to you is necessary to make the person that you are. So challenges are going to come about, and you are strong enough to get through them, and you are loved enough to get through them, and you are precious enough to get through them. Reach out for help. Don't make enemies. All of those things. Your words matter. And remember, the ripple effect. What goes around comes around. So I'd like to say goodbye, congratulations. It's been fantastic having our paths cross. And I would love it if you could go out into the world and spread kindness like confetti. Just everywhere you go, spread kindness. And I was reminded not to spread kindness like glitter, because that can be messy. But if you spread it like confetti, it will be great. Watch the ripple effect of that. Go out there. Have a wonderful life. That's all. Thanks for inviting me. Do good things. Bye.
Good evening, members of the GRS faculty, members of the board, family members, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2021. Thank you for the honor to speak to you tonight. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Lindsay Weaver, and I am a math guide and IB coordinator at Great River School. Senior class, the first thing I would like us to do is take a deep breath. Step out of autopilot and take note of what is happening. What you are doing, you are here, you made it. We have made it. we are at your high school graduation. Many of you may remember that this class was my first 10th grade class at Great River School, and we spent a lot of time together. Not only did we have Algebra 2 together 4 days a week, we also spent 3.5 hours together on Wednesday mornings in indie work. Being new to Montessori at the time, my vision of indie work was a peaceful, quiet workspace with soft, classical music gently playing in the background. Instead, the personality of this class could be summed up by their Wednesday morning preference for blasting Queen's greatest hits at 8:30 in the morning. The amount of coffee I needed on Wednesday mornings to match the energy and sociability of this class was staggering. When I think back to the incessant chatter, laughter, and general procrastination from Algebra 2, Chem, and History of the Americas work, I wonder if you weren't simply making up for the last time you would encounter later in your 11th and 12th grade years. I joke about this last time, but I also want to pause and recognize the significance of your class's collective experience with loss. As I reflected on previous graduation classes, I realized the uniqueness of your class is stark. With previous classes, we could joke about canoes tipping on key experiences, chickens and microwaves showing up in GRS classrooms and bathrooms, and the inevitable senior social hours that would happen loudly in the hallways while seniors were supposed to be in their last classes of the year. In those Wednesday morning 10th grade indie sessions we had together, one of the Queen songs blasted at 8:30 a.m. was their 1985 hit, One Vision. In it, Freddie Mercury sings, "I had a dream when I was young, a dream of sweet illusion, a glimpse of hope and unity, and visions of one sweet union. But a cold wind blows and a dark rain falls, and in my heart it shows, look at what they've done to my dream." Certainly for all of us, our dream of what the last 2 years would bring faced the reality of the cold winds and dark rains of loss. Loss of peace, proms, performances, adventures, and achievements, the loss of many dreams. During our first week of orientation this past fall, we engaged in Viktor Frankl's work, Man's Search for Meaning. You may recall that Frankl was a survivor of a concentration camp in Nazi Germany, and in his book, written within months of his liberation, he worked to challenge common assumptions of life's purpose. Instead of seeing life as a never-ending quest for happiness or comfort, or as a pursuit of power and money, Frankl argued that life is primarily a quest for meaning. Frankl refers several times to the words of Nietzsche, "He who has a why to live can bear almost any how." In his observations of his fellow prisoners, Frankl stated, "The prisoner who had lost faith in the future was doomed. With a loss of belief in the future came also a loss of spiritual hold. My wish for this class is that you find, even after all that we have lost, the audacity of courage and hope for your futures." There was darkness in our loss, but there was also something this class never lost, and that is the light of your passions, talents, and authenticity. In this class, we have robotics extraordinaires who spent hours during the pandemic leading their team to build and program a brand new robot, a robot that went on to earn top 10 in the state. We have Frisbee, basketball, and softball athletes who, after canceled 2020 competitions, responded with ingenuity and perseverance to bring teams together for mass 2021 seasons. We have a large collection of students from this class that came together to start a club this year, a distinctly successful club, Students Against Misogyny. We have students who meaningfully engage in activism and discussions with family members and their community around race, who have shown up in ways big and small to make our world different. We have bakers, writers, artists, musicians, and vaccine finders who went out of their way to share their talents with classmates and others in our community. And you know what? Perhaps the strongest members of this class are the ones whose extraordinary superpower was simply surviving and endeavoring through what our world, our community, asked this class to do. Complete high school over Zoom in the midst of global trauma while physically isolated from best friends, from classmates, from guides, and from your community. To you, to all of you, you just climbed your Everest, and to that we say, we see you. So, confession. Before giving in to this class's demand for Queen at 8:30 in the morning on Wednesdays, I don't know if I could have named a top 10 song by Queen. But I quickly became a fan, thanks to this group, and I fully commit to ensuring our three-week-old Lily's ears are fully infiltrated with Bohemian Rhapsody, Somebody to Love, and I Want to Break Free before she can crawl. And today I leave this class with my hope that you sit here today with as much belief in your futures as we, your GRS community, hold for this unique class. The class that climbed Everest and has become all the more wiser and equipped to make a profound difference in our communities and world. As you launch from this place to bring your beautiful minds and beings to our world, may the words of Queen's, "Don't Stop Me Now," ring true to your feelings. I feel lucky to know you and to have been one of your guides. I am proud of you and I will miss you. Congratulations on this accomplishment. I can't wait to hear all about your adventures and experiences as you continue to be unstoppable.
Hi everyone, happy graduation. I am so grateful that GRS has been there for me these past 9 years. And more importantly, I'm so grateful for all of the people that includes, to all of the fourth graders that started out in Miss Angela's class. I really love you guys. You all have very special places in my heart. And everyone, I don't know, I'm just really glad I grew up with you guys. And then to my teachers, you guys are really what makes GRS amazing, and I can't imagine GRS without you. Each and every single one of you have made such a big impact on my life, and I could not be more thankful, especially for all the time that you take out of your lives to go on key experiences with us and to get to know us, and yeah, love you guys.
Congratulations on making it through a very weird and stressful year. I don't think we could have made it without each other, so I'd really like to thank all of the other seniors for keeping our community strong, even in distance learning, and our guides for supporting us through it all. I can't wait to see what we all do in the future.
What's up, class of 2021? First of all, I just want to say congratulations. It's been a rough past year or so, year and a half. But I just wanted to take this time to show my gratitude and appreciation to Great River and its community. As some of you may know, I started out halfway through junior year, and all the guides and faculty just welcomed me right away. I cannot say thank you enough for how quick I was welcomed into the community with open arms and the support I was given right away from those guides. I'm very, very appreciative, and I want to say thank you. To the rest of my class, I want to say thank you for also welcoming me in quite warmly right away. I have had struggles socially in the past with the schools I've been at, and you know, I just felt really accepted right away, right from the jump. And everybody was just very kind and welcoming and supportive, and I just wanted to say thank you and congratulations.
All right, so I really want to thank all of my teachers for absolutely everything. I don't have enough thank you notes or words to even come close to showing how much gratitude I have for each and every one of you. I want to really thank my peers. You know, I was looking back and I can really think of just nothing but positive interactions I've had with each and every one of you, literally. I could not think of someone in the class of 2021 who I haven't had just a great time with. whether, you know, you helped me on my homework once, we've only talked a couple times, or we've been best friends for like 7 years. I just really love all of you, and I'm so thankful that you're who I got to graduate with. Congratulations, everyone, and good luck on the next part of your lives.
Hi, everyone. I would first like to thank Lindsay for helping me learn to love math again, and then Teresa for all the college support and the work during Elm. And then, of course, also my parents and all other guides who helped us throughout all the years at Great River.
Yeah, and I want to thank all the teachers and all my friends, and then specifically my mom and my two sisters just for supporting me through all this. So thanks, guys. Congrats on graduating.
I never thought I'd make it here, graduating from high school. It was always too far off, but here I am. Mom and Dad, thank you for always being there for me, for supporting me, and making sure I had a ride to school. My teachers, thank you for making class engaging and enjoyable and being happy to sit down and connect. And to everyone I've brushed paths with along the way, our experiences have brought us here to graduation. I'm ready to make the next step, I'm prepared, but I'm going to look back on these years fondly. So thank you, and I hope we meet again.
First off, I would love to congratulate the graduating class of 2021. We made it, and I would like to thank my guides at Great River and my family for supporting me all these years. I'm gonna sing a line of one of my favorite songs, and this is a song that I think about and I associate with all of the peers in my class, so.
But I never felt so much light than tonight. Huddled in the trenches, gazing on the battlefield, our rifles blaze away, we blaze away. Oh.
I first off want to start off by congratulating the whole class of 2021 for graduating. We made it through this rep year all online, the first ever class to do that. So that's a huge accomplishment, and congratulations to everyone for graduating. Next up, I'd like to thank all my teachers and guides, especially Mike, Randy, and Lindsay. You guys really helped me out through all my years of high school and helped to create the student of who I am and the person of who I am now, and you guys really helped. And yeah, I hope everyone has a great future and a great rest of the year.
It's a great pleasure to be giving the speech in spite of the virtual conditions that would normally limit it. I'd like to start by thanking my peers, parents, friends, and the staff at GRS for making these past 4 years everything that they were. Each and every one of you has played a massive role in my growth as both an academic and as a person, and for that I cannot express the extent of my gratitude, truly. During my time here, I've explored new passions, I've made new friends, and I now find myself in a place that I never could have foreseen when I first arrived here in 2015. In particular, I would also like to give a special thanks to the No Mythic Robotics team for fostering my interests in technology and engineering, the two fields that I intend to study going forward. It's been a lovely, albeit eccentric, 4 years at this school, but I won't forget the memories that I made here. Thank you all, it's been real.
Hello, class of 2021 and Great River teachers. I want to thank you so much for paving the way to me getting here today. I couldn't have done it without all of you. And I'm just so glad this day is finally here. This puppy wants to thank you too. Thank you so much for a great year and past 4 years. It's been amazing. Yay, we did it.
Hello, fellow graduates, teachers, friends, and family. To thank everyone who has helped me get to this point in my life seems simply impossible in 45 seconds, but to get started, I would like to thank my teachers. Because of you, I have a love of learning that is invaluable to me. Thank you. To Teresa, you have reminded me the importance of never losing sight of my dreams. Thank you. To all my classmates, thank you for all the irreplaceable memories along the way, and to my family, thank you for always supporting me. As this chapter comes to a close in our lives, I cannot thank everyone enough for the experiences and life lessons I have learned. While I think we are all ready to be done with this year, we will miss the things that shaped us over the last four. Congratulations, class of 2020.
I went to Great River in seventh grade with only one or two friends. I didn't really know what to expect, but it is such a different community than any other school. We have goats, we have a garden. I've made so many friends here. I feel so welcome. Even though I spent my senior year doing PSEO, I still feel like I have so many friends and like we're gonna stay connected in the future. I would like to thank Alexis, who's not a teacher at Great River anymore, but she really helped me become who I am. Randy, the art teacher, who really helped me with all of my art needs and because I am going to do art. And I would like to thank Anu Dean this year, who has really helped me through the whole PSEO process and the college decision making process. I will be going to Beloit in the fall. I would also like to thank you, Teresa. And yeah, we did it, 2021.
I want to start off by saying thank you. Thank you to the teachers, to the staff, and to my friends. When I hopped off the bus, I had no idea the community that waited me inside. I've been to three schools now, and GRS is the only one that has continued to allow me to grow. The community is amazing with resources and representation for all. My mother once told me that when I went off to kindergarten, I had a backpack that was entirely too big for me. I set off down the hallway and never once said goodbye. But this time, I'll remember to look over.
Hello, class of 2021. It's been a very long and interesting 9 years at Great River. Sometimes I even ask myself why I stayed at Great River for all 9 years. But when I think about the countless memories made camping at Badlands, South Dakota, bike trip, camping somewhere in Wisconsin, staying at a farm, along with the amazing teachers and staff that have helped me grow as a person, educationally and overall, and also how the staff have helped me move on in my educational life. When I think about all of that, it makes me realize that I wouldn't want to have spent the past 9 years at any other school.
You guys, we did it! We're graduating after over a year of distance learning, which is insane, and I'm so proud of each and every one of us. I have so many people that I wish I could thank, but I do not have the time, so I'm just going to do a few. I really want to thank my parents. You guys have been my greatest support system throughout my entire schooling experience, and I can't thank you enough for everything you have done for me. I also really want to thank Carolyn Neasley. You have been my teacher since seventh grade when I started at Great River, and you have had such a large impact on my life, so thank you for everything. And I also just want to thank everyone in general. This has been such a hard year for education, and we pushed through it, and we came out really strong, and I'm so excited to hear about everyone's adventures next year. Yay, 2021, we did it!
Dear class of 21 and guides, I'm so lucky to have had the opportunity to study and go to school with each and every one of you. I want to thank my guides for their endless compassion and flexibility. Even when I wasn't showing up to class or submitting assignments, I was only treated with kindness and help. I have not been an easy student to teach, but in spite of online classes, me constantly submitting assignments late and skipping class, every single teacher reached out to me with only love, compassion, care, and a push for me to be a better student in person. I'm inspired by you. I would like to voice my gratitude to Michael Flood, who is my friend and mentor. This year has been tough for everyone, and in the spirit of hope, I want to quote Van Gogh from one of his letters. It is sometimes so bitterly cold in the winter that one says, "The cold is too awful for me to care whether summer is coming or not. The harm outdoes the good." But with or without our approval, the severe weather does come to an end eventually. And one fine morning, the wind changes and there is the thaw.
Yay, we graduated. I can't believe it. Congratulations everyone. For a lot of us, it's been a super long haul. So shout out everyone who's been with me through it all since elementary, and then everyone after that, all of you, of course. I'm so grateful that I've been able to be with you guys the past few years. I'm super excited to see what all of you are gonna do later in life and what you're gonna go on to. I also want to say shout out to all the teachers, the Great River School teachers, throughout my entire academic career here, especially my teachers in the last year for everything you've done virtually. I'm super grateful. I also want to say a super special shout out to the Great River School Theater Department and the GRS Ultimate Frisbee Team. I love you guys, and you've made my experience here so great.
I just want to start out by thanking every single one of you in the class of 2021. You guys are all incredible, amazing people, and you've all touched my heart and life in ways that you probably don't know. You're all amazing human beings, and I hope you all go on to do the best things. I'd also love to thank every guide I've had over the last 9 years at Great River. It's been such a long ride, and just from my lower elementary guides, my upper elementary guides, all of my A1 and A2 guides, and all of the upper adolescent guides that I've had along the way, you guys have totally changed the way I've looked at the world, and it's just been amazing to have you all as teachers. And just a huge thank you to my whole family. You guys have been one of the biggest impacts on me in my high school career, and just, again, thank you, class of 2021. We're amazing. We graduated.
Every single person at GRS, everybody, for making this school what it is, because my past 7 years here have been absolutely incredible and honestly the best time of my life. I want to thank specifically Zach and Carolyn and Randy for putting on an amazing musical every year. That has brought me so much joy. I want to thank Emily and Patricia for writing me 2 amazing letters of recommendation. I want to thank Teresa for helping me get into college, which is a pretty important thing, and I'm so grateful to her for that. And just all in all, I don't have the words to articulate how important the GRS community is to me. It really is my family, and I mean that. And there isn't a single classmate or teacher that I don't absolutely love and respect so much. And I know we're all gonna do great things in the future, and I love you.